Space, the final frontier. These are the tutorials of... Sorry about that. Although James T. Kirk never uttered the phrase, beam me up, Scotty, Star Trek's classic transporter effect is both fun and easy to execute. From the original series until today, the effect has changed dramatically from series to series and movie to movie, but the basic principle behind the compositing technique has not. It's a crazy way to travel, spreading man's molecules all over the universe. But I'm going to teach you how to do it next on Videopia. Yeah. The modern transporter effect has three parts. One, a clean plate reveal of our crew member. Two, a simple overlay animation to add interest and hide the reveal. And three, a much more complex masked interior sparkle effect. The first two parts are trivially easy. The third, less so. Let's start with the clean plate and an easy optical camera trick that's been around for at least 100 years. Cut from the clean plate to your crew member on the planet's surface and you get a jump cut. A crossfade yields a slightly more interesting effect, but it's still not that effective. Add a sound effect and a gesture and you get I Dream of Jeannie. Definitely cute and funny, but not very impressive in terms of visual effects. A crossfade gets you a slightly more interesting effect, but it's still not very effective. What we need here is a slick, energetic, glowing overlay, like the ones I'll use here from Digital Juice. The overlay animation merely needs to cover the crossfade between the clean plate and the shot of your crew member. With appropriate audio effects, this is about as simple as visual effects get. Which is why you see it used on all sorts of sci-fi and magical fantasy shows. Shooting the basic clean plate is easy and pretty forgiving, but make sure you pay attention to the background. Too much movement in the background, such as people, vehicles, or wind-blown foliage, can totally ruin the effect. You'll also need to pay attention to continuity, since you'll be transporting from one location to another. Which means a different setup in a different environment, maybe even on different days of your shooting schedule. As you know, the media juggernaut that is Star Trek had a rocky start in the early 1960s, and the original pilot was not picked up. Production costs went over the initial $500,000 budget, and there wasn't much money left over for the second unprecedented pilot. Definitely not enough money to build shuttlecraft models, but at least enough to hire an effects guy to optically composite some Alka-Seltzer spitting in warm water with a mask and a clean plate technique that we already looked at. The classic transporter effect from the original series has a sparkly interior that's a bit more complex to create than just the overlay and crossfade. There are a few ways to create a mask to pull this off today, including grabbing a still frame from your video and hand painting out your crew member. The actual process will vary from application to application, but the traveling mat and masking principles are exactly the same. For specific details in your software, please see videopia.org. There are lots of little fun details to play with here to really sell this effect, such as the sound effects that go with the spinning up of the pattern buffer on the ship, and the duration, which is typically 2 to 4 seconds. But if there's interference, it might take a minute or more, like it did in The Enemy Within, episode number 5, or in episode number 47, Obsession, which of course is a remarkable episode with an unusually high red shirt body count. Even though the effect has changed over time, a lot. If you look closely at the latest implementation in the 2009 movie, you'll see that it still retains the tornado of particles spirit of the original. Beam over to videopia.org for explicit step-by-step video and illustrated text tutorials for your editing software. Analog 60 frame per second HD media effects files to complete your authentic project and to learn the nerdy secret of my $7 uniform. That's it for now. This has been Lieutenant Commander Franks encouraging you to keep on editing efficiently, compositing cleanly. Just remember, if Kirk ever invites you down on a planetary away mission, tell him you'd love to go, but you think you've got Rigelian fever and need to go to sickbay.